Hello, people of the internet. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. We are continuing with the viewer requests that were submitted over on the community page. A few days ago, I think it was during last weekend, I put up a community post asking for viewer suggestions on what to watch while we had a little bit of a break within the release calendar during this end of January. We had actually a very good selection of stuff that's come in, a little bit of everything. We've had some OSTs, we've had some instrumentals, we've had some songs that I've heard before but have never seen the MV for, just a really nice variety of stuff that we've listened to. And as today is yet another slow day, it's not a completely blank day. We did just finish checking out Wendy and Mellow Man's SM Station song, but we have some time today and we're going to keep going with the viewer requests one time. If you do want to get some last minute requests in, I did say that it was primarily until to keep me over until the 25th when the release schedule started back up again, but there are a couple days towards the end of the year where there are some breaks in the release schedule. So if any of you have some last minute suggestions that are hopefully copyright friendly, hop on over to the community tab. You will see my post about requests there. Feel free to drop your suggestions there. And if I haven't seen it before, or I just never heard of it and I have the time to squeeze it in, I will go and do that. Because much like today's request, coming courtesy of Somebuddy, all one word. Also spelled just like G-Friend fandom. We miss you, G-Friend. Also, thank you very much for the request. Miss Yuju. More Miss Yuju. This time, it's an official Connect Entertainment Yuju live clip, which I found out today I'm not subscribed to the official Yuju channel, which is slightly embarrassing on my part, but that has been amended. And today, we are checking out her cover of Out of Time, originally performed by The Weeknd. Don't know if I recognize the original song, but I do recognize the style of The Weeknd. And I don't know how close to the original Yuju is going to be performing it, but I am intrigued nonetheless. So, fancy transition one time, here we go. Nothing else too much in the way of what I want to say. Actually, are there any captions? No, it's just auto-generated. That's fine. The song's in English anyways, so. Plus, if you know me, I'm going to be too distracted with the music to pay attention to the lyrics anyway, so. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. That's a little bit loud in my ears. This effect is called when you have like the light glints refract in different directions, but this with the fisheye and the smoky effect. There's so much trauma in my life. I've been so cold to the walls along me, baby. I look back now and I a little bit of a delicate high note from what you drew there. And there's the powerful mid-range that she's got. Have I heard this song before? I can't tell. I love Yuju's high tone because she's got like three different ones. Like she's got that belting high tone, she's got the airy, like gentle high tone, she's got that like in the middle one. It's over. overdub, but I don't care. That harmony is gorgeous. I love that last phrase before the chorus, in the pre-chorus there, where she uses like every single tone she has in her vocal locker. It's really impressive. Nice vocal run. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous stuff. I had a thought, I forgot what I was gonna say. Oh no. Come on, brain. You can do this. Oh, right. Yuju's voice, for me, is such an enigma. Because I can't decide if I like her tone and, like, kind of like the higher energy, like. Because her solo career has primarily been this kind of like laid-back casual stuff. Even this live clip is very much appropriate for like solo career. Especially if you on like the recording album, her solo debut, like Play was this super mature, almost borderline like sensual sounding traditional instrument, including it's like really mellow song. Absolutely gorgeous. And like, I think the most energy you got out of her debut project was the intro, Bad Blood, which I am still salty that that's not a full song, because I won't lie, that may be my favorite song on the debut album, and it's an intro, it's a minute and a half long intro. But that's besides the point, that's a ramble for another day. Her solo career has been going around this like very mature, laid-back, slower sound, and I absolutely adore it. It's so cool. Because it's like, it feels like it's like a mature version of G-Friend Yuju, which is kind of to be expected. You know, she was in G-Friend for such a long time. And they debut with songs like Glass Bead, Me Gustas Tu, Shiganda Dario So Rough. Those, all those were songs that were, you know, in within the third generation, like, landscape were more, I guess, slower or like more mellower songs if you compare it to like Twice's Cheer Up or Blackpink's Boombayah. Yeah, those are very different high energy songs that maybe songs like Rough or Glassbeat didn't really have. They were more pushing along the lines of like older, maybe like Lovely's, what is kind of like colloquially known as like Christian horse girl music, which I don't necessarily understand that reference. All I know is I did tend to lean towards that type of music anyways. Like, that was my wheelhouse. But besides the point, we didn't really get to experience this side of Yuju all that much on her during her G-Friend days, apart from when she did, like, OSTs and stuff. But when once she'd gone solo and Joan was connect and had her solo debut and stuff, all of the solo content we've been getting from her has been so smooth to listen to, and it makes me wonder what her voice would sound like on like a lounge jazz type song. You know what I mean? Because I feel like she could absolutely kill that. And I kind of hope that on her like next solo release that there is a song that's like that. Where it's like you maybe have a little bit of like, I don't know, a smooth clarinet or a smooth Barry sax in the background. Just super gentle, like, percussion line in the background. Maybe an upright bass. Something along that line. Like, um, Who else has done a jazzy sound in K-pop recently? Can't think of any. The closest thing I can think of is Yuhyun Solo from Pacup Save Us, but like slow jazz. I feel like I want to see Yuju do a slow jazz song. Any Yuju content is gonna be a great time for me. She was my bias back in GFriend, and her going solo was tremendous. So much fun. As much as it was painful to see GFriend break up, seeing Yuju's solo career kind of like sprout from the bud that was buried in the ground was very heartwarming thing to see, because the last time we heard from GFriend was when they walked out into the nighttime after Mago, and that only felt way too appropriate. But yeah, that was tremendously fun, and I cannot wait for Yuju's next solo release, which I've been told is in the pipeline. It hasn't been announced yet, and there haven't been any like rumors about it as of yet, but it's in the works from what I've been told. And that makes me excited. Because play and recording album desperately deserves a follow-up. That's it for me today. Again, Somebuddy, thank you very much for the request. Again, if there are any last-minute suggestions any of you viewers would like to leave, pop on over to the community page, find a post over there, and drop a suggestion. I think there's maybe either one or two more days where I can do this before February rolls around, so last call for requests. But that's it for me today. Thank you all for watching. If you want to see more channel icons up there, you can find the back catalog of stuff watched in the past. Drop a subscription if you want to keep up to date with whenever I upload new videos. And if you want to watch another video of mine right away, YouTube recommends you watch that video down there. And until next time, bye bye.